His name is Sammy Billy. I think he's here with us now. Mr. Billy, are you there? Billy.
Hey, Matt.
I'm sorry, not
How
Billy.
You doing? How's everyone doing this morning?
We're doing well. Where are you? Are you in the hills of Missouri? Where are you exactly?
No, we're still on the road from the path of totality, the cult that I started a few months ago to honor this eclipse. Well, as you can see, the world is still here, and that's a problem.
I'm glad you acknowledge that, because most people aren't even acknowledging that it didn't end. They just like make it believe they never said anything. You were expecting the end of the world, yes?
Yeah, well, I mean, let's not get crazy, but the people that I've brought in to follow me have paid about $5,000 each to be here, and they are pissed.
I could imagine. I guess they ran up credit card debt and all that kind of stuff too on the way to. I would have, if I believed in it, I would have probably maxed out my credit.
Yeah, 100%, we had some issues too with the path of totality. We were trying to drive it the entire time, and my driver, he can't drive that fast, so people were upset. And and I think they're kind of mad too that I skimped on those eclipse glasses, because some of them are complaining about their eyes today, you know, fucking little cookies,
you know? Oh, so you just put like regular sunglasses and basically let them look?
Yeah, you know, I pulled out my Bible and I said, it says right here in chapter 5, verse 6, Proverbs 82:92, look at the eclipse, motherfucker. But that's what it said. So, I mean, what do you want from me?
I think we need a fact check on that. I'm not like a Bible scholar, but I think somebody needs to check on that somewhere.
That's in the new millennial version. That's in the new millennial version. That's right after Second Opinions.
Yeah. Exactly. And like, my neck is still killing me from the drive. We're somewhere currently in Idaho, I think. I don't know.
Idaho.
Did you guys have the group orgy there in Idaho? Were you planning that? Or did you guys plan on doing it in a moving truck on the path of totality? I was just curious how that worked out.
You know, it's always the same with you guys. Just because someone starts a religious cult, it has to be orgies and all sorts of sexual things. No, we are a completely self-masturbatory group. That's what we do in a group. We don't gangbang. What do you think we are, sickos?
Navikium. Like cults, I think all cults have a sexual element to it, though. No? Oh, you're not banging anybody in the cult?
The thing about running a cult, you know, you gotta wear a lot of different hats. You know, you gotta be able to just talk to people like a normal person. Now, like when we have our
that's how a normal person talks. All right.
Yeah, when we have our ceremony of induction, I will wear this hat to show the women that I am fully aroused without being naked.
Well, that's all nice.
Right. Okay.
I'm fully aroused right now, everybody.
I know. I'm a little aroused, to be honest with you.
I'm fully bricked over here. I'm not even going to lie.
Wow.
But yeah, that's good to hear, because especially since the world didn't end, you know, I need a different...
Has it been rescheduled? This end of the world? Are you continuing on? Do you have plans for another round of world-ending fun?
I think I might. I mean, this has been pretty fun being this cult leader, but I'm gonna have to take a break for a bit, because I think the next one's not like until 2042, and the way some of these, like I said, the way some of these people have been acting ever since the world didn't end, they've been getting on my nerves. And you know, I got to teach him lessons and things like that, like the Lord would want. Like this one guy, Jimmy, man, he's always complaining. But when when the Lord choked him out last night in his sleep, he realized the word is true.
Wow. Interesting. So all these people, are they basically homeless now? Did they give up their homes? Do they have any place to go, or are they with you forever?
Well, no, they got a place to live. I am not heartless, everybody. I made them sign a 20-year lease. Now they have to pay me, $700 a month to live on my compound. And if you want to know what my compound is like, it's a beautiful half-acre lot with a swing set. So what more do you want?
Is there interest in your compound? I mean, is there compound interest?
Compound interest.
Oh, there's going to be. And there's going to be so much pounding interest.
Knew it. I fucking knew it.
Time somebody took at least acknowledged that the predictions weren't wrong, weren't right. Now, do you know what went wrong with this? Where did we go wrong? How were we so wrong about this?
Well, I think the reason we were wrong, like after the eclipse happened and we were all let down, I made a good call to my friend RFK Jr. And he said to me that the reason the eclipse didn't end the world is because those Jewish space lasers got involved yesterday. Because I'm not sure if you noticed, there was some other bright lights in the sky. And we all know what that was.
Right. We don't all know what that was. But that kind of gives it some explanation about what it was. Jewish space lasers. Now, how do we know they're Jewish? Are they circumcised? I mean, how do we tell that the lasers are actually Jewish?
That I don't know. I mean,
cheap. We got them cheap. Is that?
I think they go when they go off. They go shalom.
I can't say. I mean, I'd have to talk to my good friend Bobby. That's what I call him. You know, Bobby Kennedy. I just got to talk to Bobby and find out what the deal is.
Interesting. All right. I guess you're going to be continuing on with this cult. I guess we'll continue to call it a cult. Now, do you have an official like name of the cult? Is it just like it's not like Heaven's Gate or any? Do you have you branded it?
Sorry, Matt, but we actually took the name of your institute because of those 42 children that you have. So we are the cult of the 11 Finger Institute. You're welcome for that.
Oh, well, thank you. By the way, I put out a reel last night for people who are interested in enjoying the suffering. I asked AI to create an enjoy the suffering reel. Pretty good. But they changed the language on it a little bit to the beauty and brokenness, but it gets the point across.
Yeah, it's funny that you mentioned suffering because every day I have to listen to at least three or four people say, oh, we're suffering. That's not my problem. You know, that's
right.
That's a middle manager problem in the cult. Huh?
Do you have middle management in the cult? I mean, a structure, a corporate structure there?
Oh yeah, we have it all. We have a whole org chart, so that way when people can, you know, when they have problems, they don't have to bring all that stuff to me. Because you know, I'm with God, and we don't want to listen to your problems all the time. So that's why we have middle managers.
Is there a trial membership before full on joining just to see if you know if you feel comfortable, if you fit in, or do you just have to go full pull and just go for it?
I think you just need to visit me and you will sit down and you can show me what that mouth does on the scripture and we'll see what happens.
You had me at sit down and see what that mouth does, so I might be making a visit. As long as I can get in there, I'll be there.
You know what would be good? Oh, I'm sorry. You can answer our friend Steven there if you like.
I was just going to say, yeah, it's a very important. It keeps us all very relaxed.
I'm pretty relaxed right now. But I got to admit, I'm a little bit tense about my first guest, who I was definitely certain would show up on time. And I was a little concerned that we might not have enough time to talk to you because she was going to show up exactly on time. She's a little late, so I'm going to have to write her an email. But what would be really helpful is like a outline on how to start a cult. Do you, have you any? Can you give us any kind of I don't know, a primer on how to start a cult, because I would like to someday, maybe.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I would suggest that most people should do it. The first thing you'll want to do is probably get a career in sales, like a car salesman, because that teaches you the basics of just lying to people on a daily basis. I mean, not sense. Lying. It's stretching the truth.
Right.
What if, then you you're have a background, what if you have a background in politics? Would that be beneficial?
What was that? You were breaking up.
What if you have a background in politics? Would that be beneficial?
No, his background is trees.
I'm sorry. Yes, you're right. I didn't. Yeah.
His background is the woods.
I stand corrected.
I don't see a damn politician back there. Now, are they wild animal? Where are you in? It looks like you're in nature. Like, you're not really anywhere near, like, civilization at all.
We're actually at a truck stop because we ran out of money. So some of my supporters are in the bathroom, you know, helping out and getting us some money for the roof.
Oh, the old rub and tug for a little bit of gas money. Now, this is interesting to me. How many people are in the cult?
It depends. Like on this trip, we took about 25 with us all in this car. It's a bit cramped, but you know, we managed.
25 at $5,000 a piece, and you ran out of money.
Yeah, well, I mean, that money is like, you know, Matt, just like any corporation, that money goes into a different bucket.
Oh, and, the expenses, yeah, overhead. I get it.
Yeah, and since we're in a precarious times, you know, I have to work in all cash with me. So, honestly, I can't trust these people with having money around. I got to keep that shit locked up.
Gotcha. All right. Well, we wish you good luck out there and with the cult and whatever. Maybe check back in next end of the world, or, you know, even if it's like a close to the end of the world event, like, you know, like most of humanity will die, but some people will be left, or whatever you have happening there. Just check in sometime.
Yep. You know, Matt, we can only hope.
We can only hope. All right. Well, have a great day and bye for now. Sammy Billy, folks, you guys talk amongst yourselves. I'm gonna get in touch with Sonia and say where are you? GD's waiting to hear about racism.